In this lesson, we will add a new attribute to the supplier entity in the supplier module, and we will see how to reflect this change in the e-bidding module. So let's go into the suppliers application and open the suppliers module. I will add a new attribute in the supplier entity, and this will be the tax ID number. And I'm going to change the data type to text, and this will be a 50 character long attribute. And I want to use this attribute in the screens that I have in my application. So in the supplier show, let me drag and drop the attribute into the show record. And also on the supplier edit. Drag and drop the attribute again. There. Okay. Let's publish this change in the supplier module. One thing that you'll notice in this operation we just did is that there's a new message. There's a warning message here in the one-click publish tab that we haven't seen before. And what happened here is that when a public element changes, modifications are not automatically propagated to the other modules. The OutSystems platform issues a warning to refresh the references in those modules. So this change that we did in the supplier entity has impact, in this case, in the e-bidding module that becomes outdated, and we need to refresh these references. So we'll need to open the e-bidding application. Let me just go here into the e-bidding. And you'll notice that also on the module, we have the same warning here. And if we open this module, we have a new message here. And again, when changes to public elements may have impact on your module, the OutSystems platform prompts you to update those elements. And that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to answer yes here on this prompt. And as you can see here in the Add Remove References window, I have the indication that the supplier's module is outdated and it has elements that have been modified on this module. And these elements are, in this case, it's just one element that was changed, is the supplier entity. And even if I expand here the supplier entity, I can see that this was the tax ID attribute was added. So we have all this information to see what happened to this module and for us to take action. What I want to do now is to refresh all these references. So I'm going to refresh here using this option. And I'm going to confirm this with the OK button. And now I want to use this new attribute that will appear here in the supplier entity. Here it is, tax ID number. I want to use this in the pop-up info balloon that we created in the previous lesson. So I'm going to drag and drop the attribute into the show record. There it is. And now we'll be able to see this information in the e-bidding application. So let me just publish, and then we'll go into the browser and we will test all this. Okay, first of all, before we test the e-bidding application, we need to test the changes in the supplier's application. So let me open here the supplier's application. I'll need to log in. And I'm going to the Abbott Laboratories show page. And there you have it, tax ID number. I need to edit this information, so let me edit here the tax ID number. Let me fill this in with a value like 36-0698440. And let me save it. Okay, we have that information stored. Now, let me go back here and open the e-bidding application. I'll need to log in. And remember that we, we stored a bid for this first product request, and this bid was by Abbott Laboratories. So if we open the info balloon, there we have it. Now we have the tax ID number in our e-bidding application. And that's it.